What an incredible sight. It's such a beautiful setting. Brighton was the first ski resort in Utah and one of the first in America. May I be the first to welcome all of you to this significant event, the marriage of Alex and Whitney. For those who don't know, I am Jason Marsh. You can also call me Reverend if you like tonight. I'm the oldest brother of Whitney, and in about 20 minutes, the brother-in-law of Alex. Pretty pumped about that. This is my first time performing a wedding, so if everyone would be nice, I'd really appreciate that. I will be honest, I'm absolutely terrified to be up here, but I'm also incredibly humbled and honored. I love Alex and Whitney so much, and I'm truly grateful to be a part of their special day. Before we get started, I'd like to take a second to recognize the significance of this moment. Alex and Whitney, your lives have been filled with experiences that have prepared and led you to this day. I'd like for you to take a minute, take a deep breath. You can go ahead and do that. Relax.
I think you need to thank you.
I need deep breath as well. And just savor this moment. Look out at this audience. All of these people are here for you. How cool is that? There is so much love felt at this time as you two stand side by side, surrounded by loved ones. This day will be one you will remember for the rest of your lives. I hope that you will never forget the love and the commitment that you feel for each other, and the love and the support that you feel from all of your friends and your family that are here today. You ready? Get started? The moment's been savored? Okay.
I don't know.
Okay, today we take ourselves out of the usual routines of daily living to witness a unique moment in the lives of Alex and Whitney. Today they will join their lives in the union of marriage.
Next page.
To everyone here, thank you for coming. Alex and Whitney are happy to share this significant moment with you. They have known most of you for many years. You raised them. You grew up with them. You lived next to them. You went to school with them or you worked with them. You are their friends and family. Because you are the ones who supported the ceremony. They have prepared some words for them, which I'm going to read at this time. Alex wrote the following to Alice and Jay, his mom and dad. He said, "Thank you both for being my parents, for always wanting the best for Andy and I, for supporting both of us in whatever it may be. Basketball, you never missed a game no matter where it was. Soccer, Pokemon cards, that's probably a story there. Backyard wrestling, or letting us shred all your blocks of cheese. I know now that was probably pretty expensive. I know the sacrifices you both showed me what hard work and dedication looks like. I know I haven't been perfect, but you never made me feel like I was anything but perfect, just the way I am. I'm very lucky to have you as parents and to grow up the way I did. This wedding isn't just about Whitney and I, it's about all those who helped us get here, and you played one of the biggest roles. I love you both very much. Thank you for being my mom and dad." Whitney had this to say to her parents, Jeff and Kathy. "Thank you for being the best parents I could have asked for. You've taught me some of the most valuable qualities and have helped shape me into who I am today. You've always loved and accepted me for who I am and have supported me through everything. You never once doubted who I was meant to be or what I wanted to do with my life. You've been by my side through everything. I'm so lucky to have both of you as my parents. I love you both so much." And I'd just like to add a thank you to both parents who have sacrificed so much for Alex and Whitney, and you are appreciated and loved. A wedding day is often a day when couples miss family members who have passed to the other side. Alex would like to recognize his grandparents, Harvey and Jetta Okeson, and Steve and Clazina Vandermeer. Whitney would like to recognize her grandpas, Howard Paul, also known as Howie, and Bill Marsh. These are people who have had a significant impact on Alex and Whitney's lives, and I'm sure they are watching and here with us today. Now, if I may, I'm new to this, so I don't know if this is tradition or not, but I'm going to do it anyways. I'm just going to share a few words. First to you, Whitney, because I know you both so well. Then to you, Alex, and then together as a couple. Whitney, the first recollection I have of you was in November 1990.
Whoa.
It was a few weeks before you were born. It was a cold night, and a neighbor was picking me and some other neighborhood kids up from a junior jazz basketball practice. I was one of the best players on the team, so he had me sit in the front. Usually that's how I went. On the ride home, the neighbor, hold on, next page, who knew our family well and knew Mom would be having a baby soon, asked if I was excited to be getting a new younger sister. I told him that I was. The neighbor then asked what we were going to name you. I told them Whitney, which I thought was really cool because you have the same name as the popular singer Whitney Houston. I don't know why I remember that, but I did. I know this is totally a random memory, but it has always stuck with me. I will always remember my excitement and love I had for you before you were even born. Since you were born, you've been an absolute blessing and a joy to me and to our entire family. You are so fun. You have such a fun personality. You light up a room when you walk in. You are the person that everyone wants to be like. You have a great work ethic. You are kind and loving and would do just about anything for anyone. You are beautiful on the inside and out. One thing about Whitney is she's always up for an adventure. She is fearless. Recently, our family went on a vacation to Zions National Park. While there, a few of us hiked Angel's Landing. There's a picture up front you may have seen of Whitney and Alex at the top of this hike called called Angel's Landing, which I just said. This hike is utterly terrifying, at least to me. You hike 2 miles, which are pretty grueling, and then you come to the last half mile. The last half mile is strenuous and lined with numerous sharp drop-offs and narrow paths. Some of those narrow parts have chains to help you from falling 1,500 feet to your demise, so just a lot of fun. Great hike. I wanted to do this hike, but we had my 3 little girls, so I had to take them with me, or I would have gone. I totally would have done it. Yeah. But Whitney did. She did the hike, and she handled it like a boss. She reached the top, took a few selfies, and was back in no time. And when she got back, I asked her, you know, like, how was the hike? Like, I was living my dreams through her, thinking, oh, it's going to be terrifying. But she was like, oh, it's no big deal. You know, piece of cake. But that's just who she is. She's just fearless. So when I'm up for an adventure, Whitney is one of the first people I call because I know she will be in. As an example, I love to see scary movies. She's the only one that will go with me to see them. So at least a couple times a year, her and I go see a scary movie together. And I really look forward and love those times together. Whitney, you're the best little sister I could have, one of my best friends. I love you, and I'm so proud to be your brother.
What is that?
I've watched you as you've grown up. I've watched as you put yourself through college. You bought your own house. You are an incredible person and have accomplished so much. With Alex by your side, you're going to accomplish even more. Okay, Alex, my man. The first time I met you was on July 4th, 2015. Whitney's friend Shelby was throwing a barbecue and a swim party to celebrate the holiday. At the time, you'd been dating Whitney for a little bit, but it was our first time meeting you. I will never forget that time because it's the first time I had a real man crush. Your hair was dark and slicked back, wet from the pool. Sunglasses were on. You had a great physique, a great tan. You were dreamy that day. I told my wife you were one of the most handsome guys I'd ever seen, that you had to be a model. My man crush has kind of been a running joke ever since. But in our family, Alex is everyone's favorite. The guys like him because he's athletic, funny, and has an impressive collection of Jordan basketball shoes. The girls like him because he loves the TV show The Bachelor. True story. Bachelor Nation. The kids like him because he is funny and will play with them for hours. And both of my grandmas like them because, and I quote, he is handsome. However, my favorite thing about Alex is the respect, kindness, and love he shows toward everyone in our family, but especially the women. He's very kind and sweet to my mom. He treats her with reverence and respect. Because of that, they have a sweet relationship. One weekend, Jamie and Whitney went on a trip together. Knowing that Carrie, Jamie's partner, would be home alone, Alex invited her to go to a party with him, which I think Carrie regretted. She's not as young as she used to be. They went out and had a great time, but it was such a kind and thoughtful gesture that meant so much to both Jamie and Carrie. Alex has a great deal of love and respect for Whitney. Before asking Whitney to marry him, he invited my dad and all of our brothers to lunch, which are 4 of us, so there's quite a few. There, he nervously asked not only my dad, but all of us for our blessing to marry Whitney. That was a really cool moment. There was an incredible amount of love felt at that lunch, and it was a day none of us will ever forget. Alex, I speak on behalf of my entire family when I say we love you and are so grateful you are a part of our family. So glad that you chose Whitney and Whitney chose you. Together, you two are going to build an incredible life. Okay, now if I can just give a little advice to you as a couple. I feel as a reverend, it's my duty. You probably don't need it, as you are already relationship goals AF, but here we go anyway. I'm going to start out with a scripture. It's in Proverbs 21:19, and it reads, "It is better to dwell in the wilderness than with a contentious and angry woman." That's pretty powerful advice right there, and that's literally all you need. Alex, don't tick off Whitney, and Whitney, don't be an angry and contentious woman. You can figure that out. You'll be set. You'll be set. No, unfortunately, I have a little bit more advice than that. Alex and Whitney, I hope you two will serve each other. When I think back in my life, the times when I'm truly the happiest is when I'm serving other people. And who better to serve than your spouse? By doing so, you will forget your own problems and develop a deeper love for each other. Never take each other for granted. Don't ever think that you can put minimal effort into your marriage and everything will be okay. You get out of your marriage what you put into it. Marriage is not 50-50. It is 100-100. 100. You need to put everything you have into your marriage. Be unselfish. Put each other first. Be patient. When you make a mistake, say you are sorry. Be quick to forgive. Do not hold grudges. Say I love you to each other every day. Never keep secrets from each other, unless it's a surprise birthday party or something like that. That's okay. Never lie to each other. Lies break trust, and trust is the foundation of marriage. Be each other's biggest fan and encourager, not his or her biggest critic. Support each other. A strong marriage is not two strong people at the same time. It is usually a husband and wife. Taking turns being strong for each other in moments when the other feels weak. Celebrate birthdays, promotions, anniversaries, the big things, the little things. Don't let life's moments pass. When given the choice to sit it out or dance, dance. Make time together a priority. Budget for a consistent date night. Spend quality time together without phones or distraction. Time is the currency of relationships, so consistently invest in time into your marriage. Laugh together, cry together, pray together. Always answer the phone when your husband or wife is calling. Never talk badly about your spouse to others. Always wear your wedding ring. Create a lifetime of good memories, one memory at a time. And finally, never, ever, ever give up on each other. Alex and Whitney, I'm so happy for you, and I'm so excited for your future. Together, you will accomplish incredible things and have an amazing life. Together, you will find joy and love you didn't know existed or thought was even possible. Together, life will be so sweet. I love you both and wish you all the happiness in the world. Alex and Whitney have prepared vows for each other. Whitney will say her vows first, followed by Alex.
Yeah. Mine are a little long. Okay. So, I picked our San Marini song because I heard it, and I immediately thought of you because my life has truly been in a better place when you came along. I can't tell you how many people told me I seem so much happier and more like myself since I met you. I am so happy and feel so complete with you by my side. I truly believe we were meant to be together from the beginning. We grew up 4 blocks from each other, went to the same schools, knew each other's siblings, and even worked at the same car wash together. But even though we had so many connections, we had never actually met until years later, and I truly believe that it was all because about the right timing for us to walk into each other's lives. My life has been so full since you've been in it. You came into my life and everything so became so easy for me. Our relationship is the type of relationship I've been searching for, but I never thought I could find. I never thought it was possible to have. And I'll admit it, it took me a minute to actually accept what was right in front of me because I believed it was too good to be true. You've taught me the true meaning of unconditional love. We live in a world where everyone tries to be perceived as perfect and flawless. You've seen all my flaws and faults, You've seen me at my most vulnerable times, and yet you still continue to love me. You accept me for who I am, and you always encourage me to continue being my true, authentic self. I promise to love you unconditionally, just as you love me. I promise to support you in all of your goals and aspirations. I promise to always be on your team and by your side. In the 3 short years we've been together, we have been through a lot, and we have learned to overcome and accomplish things together. We've made a pretty great team. I wouldn't want anyone else by my side to continue navigating my life through with. I thought I knew forgiveness until I met you. You have a heart of gold, and you forgive so quickly. Sometimes I find that it surprises me how quick you are to forgive and forget and move forward with living life. I promise to always be forgiving to you. I promise to always be loyal to you. I promise to always be your friend. You are the definition of a true friend and loyal friend, and I'm lucky to call you my best friend. You're selfless and genuine. You bring out the fun side of me, and you help me to not take life so seriously. You remind me to enjoy the moment instead of worrying about what will happen next. I love waking up to you every morning and going to bed with you by my side every night. And I can't wait to continue having you by my side at the start and end of every night for the rest of my life. Thank you for being you. You're my person. I love you, and I can't wait to be your wife.
I'm supposed to follow that. I was gonna freestyle this, but we all know how that goes. March was always my favorite time of year. March Madness is in full swing. The NBA season is ramping up for the playoffs. And for anyone that knows me, knows that I love basketball. Little did I know, as I sat in my car checking March Madness scores on my phone, too nervous to meet a girl that was already inside waiting for me, that March was about to become an even greater month. That March was about to become even greater because I was about to meet my new best friend, my girlfriend, my roommate, and now my soon-to-be, well, you're my wife.
Now.
It's hard to put into words how you affected my life. You have shown me what a real relationship is and what it truly means to love someone unconditionally. We have had our hurdles these past 3 years, but we stuck by each other and loved each other through it all. You truly are an amazing person who can light up any room. You went from being the shy new girl to everyone's best friend. I love you so much. I cannot wait to see what adventures our future holds. I promise to love you, always drink the last Coke, always eat all the protein bars,
always
leave the protein shakers tight and unable to open. I promise to annoy you. I promise to blow the crap out of you whenever I can. But I promise to always love you, and I'll always be your best friend. Thank you for being you with me. I don't know where I'd be without you. I love you so much.
Okay, I think we're ready to do this. Okay, seeing that no moment is without meaning, we ask that you take this marriage as the beginning of your lives together. Today signifies the creation of a new home and a new family for you both. May you be fulfilled by each other's love and friendship. May you be overjoyed by the promises you're about to make and the life together you will create. Remember that in every marriage, there are good times and bad times, times of joy and times of sorrow. Marriage is a journey, a time of adventure and excitement, enhanced by the love, trust, dedication, faith that you share in one another. May the promises you make to one another today be lived out to the end of your lives. Tomorrow can bring you the greatest of joys, but today, it all begins. That said, Alex and Whitney, do you, with your family and friends as your witnesses, present yourselves willingly and of your own accord to be joined together in marriage?
We do.
We practice this. Will you promise to care for each other in the joys and sorrows of life, come what may, and to share the responsibility for growth and enrichment of your life together?
We do.
Yes, we will.
We will.
We will.
Actually, we will.
Okay. Hold this. You repeat after me.
I, Alex, take you, Whitney.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
I give it to you.
I give it to you.
In the presence of these witnesses.
In the presence of these witnesses.
I promise to stay by your side.
I promise to stay by your side.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
As well as through the good times and the bad.
As well as through the good times and the bad.
I promise to love you without reservation.
I promise to love you without reservation.
Comfort you in times of distress.
Comfort you in times of distress.
Encourage you to achieve all of your goals.
Encourage you to achieve all your goals.
Laugh with you.
Laugh with you.
Cry with you.
Cry with you.
Grow with you.
Grow with you.
Body, mind, and spirit.
Body, mind, and spirit.
Always be open and honest with you.
Always be open and honest with you.
Cherish you as long as we both shall live.
And cherish you as long as we both shall live.
A lot of words. Whitney, please repeat after me. I, Whitney, take you, Alex.
I, Whitney, take you, Alex.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
I give to you in the presence of these witnesses.
I give to you in my present witnesses.
What? Too long.
I promise to stay by your side.
I promise to stay by your side.
Sickness and in health.
And in sickness and in health.
Joy and in sorrow.
And in joy and in sorrow.
As well as through the good times and the bad.
As well in the good times and the bad.
I promise to love you without reservation.
I promise to love you without reservation.
Comfort you in times of distress.
Comfort you in times of distress.
Encourage you to achieve all of your goals.
Encourage you to achieve all of your goals.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Grow with you in body, mind, and spirit.
Grow with you body, mind, and spirit.
Always be open and honest.
Always be open and honest with you.
Cherish you.
Cherish you.
As long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Now we will have the ring.